the digital challenge is at this moment, in my view, not so much the threat of cyber war, which is often quoted, but it is the spreading of false information, of manipulating information in a way that benefits populism, that drives extremist parties forward, that helps terrorists. We found, for example, that the terrorist who killed a large number of people just before Christmas in Berlin, he found the instruction booklet, how to steal a lorry, how to drive it into a large mass of people to kill a maximum number of non-believers. He found that on a website designed by the so-called Islamic State. He didn't even need to talk to anyone from that group. He simply wrote it down from the website. That's how effective, unfortunately, these methods have become.
You have not only proposed questions about digital security, you've provided some answers as well. Could you enlighten us on perhaps some of the ways forward for not just Europe, but the rest of the world?
Well, I think there are actually three areas or three areas of issues that we should focus on. First is we need a lot more expertise. That includes education. Our children, but also the adults, need to understand how to distinguish between truth and falsehood. They need to understand how can they make sure that what they read on Facebook or in the internet, how can they make sure that that is not manipulated false information. Second is resources. We need to devote a lot more resources to protecting the free internet, to protecting against cyber activities. We have found that it is so easy to affect our critical infrastructure, to steal money from banks, but it has also become evident that the most vulnerable of our critical infrastructures are our political institutions, our election processes, the rule of law, the credibility of our government institutions, the courts, the parliament, the government. That is at stake, and that is why more resources need to go into that. And lastly, we need rules. Cyberspace is today like the Wild West. There are no rules except for those who have a weapon in their hand, if they want to use it. And if they use it, they are not being punished for it because there's no one there who will arrest them. That cannot go on. We need rules. I think we need a cyberspace Geneva Convention. The Geneva Convention is, of course, the body of rules governing military conflict. And if we think of cyber also as an area of conflict, then we should develop a body of rules. And in order to maintain and to guard and to verify and to protect these rules, I think we should build a separate international institution, a kind of a United Nations institution, organization, devoted to the protection of the cyberspace.
Ischinger, thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.